Let's look at the details of the three blocks of the DIG and DIGNAR models. The private demand block describes the behavior of households. They decide how much to consume by maximizing the expected discounted flows of the utility, happiness, that they derive from consuming goods and services, while being subject to a budget constraint. All households pay taxes on their income and consumption and receive transfers from the government. There are two types of consumers, savers and non-savers. Savers have access to debt and assets, such as financial assets and physical capital. Therefore, they also decide how much to invest. This allows them to smooth consumption over time. That is, if at any time their income is below their desired consumption, they can borrow or withdraw from their assets to consume more than their income. Non-savers do not have access to assets or debt, and therefore are forced to consume their current income in every period. The private supply block describes the behavior of firms which work in perfectly competitive markets with flexible prices. Firms are grouped into two sectors. Firms in one sector produce a traded good, and firms in the other sector produce a non-traded good. For production, firms use private capital, labor, and government-supplied public capital like infrastructure. In DIGNAR, there is also a natural resource sector whose production and prices are assumed to be exogenous and subject to windfalls, for example, large price increases. These windfalls can induce Dutch disease effects. These denote an appreciation of the real exchange rate and an output loss in the traded sector. These dynamics may cause a persistent decline of the traded sector output, which is typically perceived as problematic by policymakers and economists because the traded sector is considered an engine of growth. The policy block describes the behavior of the government. It includes a budget constraint and policy reaction functions, which determine how the government sets some of its revenues and expenditures in response to debt dynamics. The path for public investment is set exogenously. How much investment in public capital increases the stock of public capital depends on the efficiency of this investment. The models do not feature monetary policy decisions. The government is assumed to have access to three types of loans for which it pays interest: concessional external loans, like aid, external commercial loans, and domestic loans. The interest rate that the government pays on external debt increases with the government external debt to GDP ratio. This reflects the traditional view that as external indebtedness grows, so does the risk of default. The government also collects taxes and makes transfers to consumers. In DIGNAR, the government also receives revenues from royalties and has access to a natural resource fund. That is, a sovereign wealth fund that can collect the savings from resource windfalls.